This is a getting started video for Google Drive. In this video, I will show you how to create a Google account and how to access your Google Drive and other Google applications. And then we will have a quick tour of user interface of Google Drive and what are the functions available. So the first thing, to access any of the Google products, you need to have a Google account. And the best way to get a Google account is by creating a Gmail account. Gmail is one of the most used product of Google. So to create a Google account, you type support.google.com in your browser and you will see this screen. On this screen, click on Gmail and then create a Gmail account. Create an account again, click here. And then you have to fill the details and your Gmail address of your choice, which you want to get. For example, I might like to get my name here. So I would type tahiryaqub@gmail.com. And then you have to put your password twice and then you click next. If this Gmail is not available, it will show you a message and it will show you few options here. You either select any of those available options or you try again. So you try your second choice and then click next. So in this way, you can do until you get your Gmail address of choice. And once you get the address, then you have to log in by using that address and the password which you have selected at this stage. And now I assume that you have created your Google account and now you have access to Google products. So Google offers two types of products. One are the free products and the other are business products. So all this course I will be using the free Gmail account. So you don't have to pay any of these plans to get access to your Google Drive. Google Drive is completely free. With every Gmail account, which is also free, you get 15 GB of free cloud storage on Google computers, which is called Google Drive. But if you are a business, then there is another product line, which is called G Suite. And these are the rates for different G Suite products. Now, once you have created a Google account, you will get a default avatar, something like this. Any alphabet, the first alphabet of your name or any other alphabet you might get. So this is your avatar. You can change this to your picture or image. But once you logged in, you will see your avatar on the right hand side. And if you hover over that, you will see your email address associated with this avatar and your name. So this email address I have created recently for my upcoming course. There are a couple of ways you can access Google Drive once you logged in. The first way is click on these 9 dots and then click on Google Drive. And now my screen will reload and now I will see the root of my Google Drive. On this screen, you can have two types of views and these views types can be selected from here. Currently, I am in the grid view. And if I want a list view, I can click on that icon and it will show my Google Drive in list format. Now all files are like this with some details, owner of the files, when this file was last modified and what is the size of the file. So all details are displayed. So let's go back to grid view again. This view has three different sections. The first section is quick access section, where all the files are located which I have recently accessed. The second section is a folder section. I have currently only two folders. And then there is a file section in which all the files are located. If I want to upload a file from computer, I click on this little triangle. I click on upload files. It will show me this dialog box and here I can upload any file from my computer if I want. So at this time, I just cancel this. I can also upload a folder from here. I can also create a new folder and that folder will be in this location here at my at the root of my Google Drive. From this dialog box, I can also access Google application, Google Docs, which is similar to Microsoft Word, then Google Sheet, which you can say that's similar to Microsoft Excel, or Google Slides, which is somewhat similar to PowerPoint. We also have some more applications and two of them are very commonly used, Google Forms and Google Drawings. All of these applications require a separate course. They are such a detailed applications, but I will put one video for every application in this Google Drive course as well. And if you want, I also have a Google Docs course, which is 31 lectures and 1.5 hour of video contents. I will put a link in the description. From time to time, I offer free coupons. The other way to access Google application and to create a new document is by clicking on New. So if I click New, and now if I click on Google Docs, a new Google document will be created. So just click on this. I just want to show you how this looks. So this is Google Document. You should understand that Google Document, Google Sheets, all these are associated with your Google Drive. So in this Google Drive course, we will be using Google Docs occasionally to make some ideas clear and to make some functions of Google Drive more clear to you. So Google Docs and Google Drives, they are associated and they work hand in hand. So this is an important point to note. So currently I just closed this. You don't have to save any of your Google documents because all your Google documents are automatically saved. Your sheets and your slides are also automatically saved on your Google Drive. There is actually no save button. Now there are a few more things. Let's say I click on this file, and now this is the preview of the file. And if I go back once again, so first let's start with this navigation menu. This is navigation menu, and on this menu, this was your drive. Then we have shared with me. If you click on that, if anyone else has shared anything with you, any file or folder, that will appear in this location. Then recent, I have already explained, these are the recent files. Then start. Start means if you have starred any of your files, if you can star your files. You star just for general importance purpose, something like that, you can also do that, and those starred files will appear here. Now if you delete any file, that file will come to trash folder, and this is just like recycle bin folder. You can restore from your trash folder back to the folder from where you deleted. So if I click on trash folder, these are the files which I have recently deleted. If I want to restore any of these files back to my original location, I just click on the file, and then there is this little arrow, a round arrow, which says restore from trash. If I click here, this file will go back from where it was deleted. So this is how you recover the deleted files, and I will show you how to delete a file in a minute. Then backups, where you can create backups of your Android devices. Like Android phone or Android tablet, you can create backups here, and I will show you in this course. You can see the storage, how much you have used out of your 15 GB, and make sure that you don't keep any of the unwanted emails and their attachments, because all those will count towards your storage. The only thing which does not count against your free storage are your Google documents, or Google Sheets, or Google Slides. All these things will not be counted against your free storage of 15 GB. And 15 GB is a lot of storage if you use wisely. And if you want to buy, you can upgrade storage. I have recently bought 100 GB for one of my accounts, and that cost me $25 per year for 100 GB. So you can upgrade to, there are various tiers available for you. So let's go back to my drive. Now, if I select a file by clicking once on that file, a context menu will appear here. This is the file context menu. Means that this menu will only appear if you have selected a file. Now, there are a couple of options here. So most options are in these three dots. If I click on these three dots, now I can move this file to any of the folders, any of other folders or any other location. I can add to start. If I click add to start, one file added to start. And if I now go to start, and now the start file appears here. Let's go back to drive. Now let's talk about some other options. You can rename the file. And the best thing about Google Drive is that you can store many versions of your files. And you can go back to any of the previous versions. And this is you do in this area, and we will talk about this. You can make a copy of this. You can report an abuse, or you can download to your computer. Now come back to the next option. This is the remove option. You can remove any file or delete any file, and the file will go to the trash folder. Then this is the preview. If I click on that, I will see the preview of that file. It's an image, so I can see the image in a large preview manner. So now let us click on any of these documents. And let's say I want to share this document to someone, then I will click on this share option. And now I have this link available. This is the link which I can share to anyone. I can just click on this and copy this link and send via email to someone, or I can directly put the email address of that person here. So if I click on this triangle, I can see that I have three levels of access. The lowest level is only view access. I can give access to view the document. Then I can give access to comment on this document, or I can give full access to edit the document. So I select the level of access, I type the email of that person, I click done, and an email will be sent to that person. If you have given someone access and you want to remove the access, we will talk this in the advanced options later on in this course. On the right hand side, you have options to access Google Calendar, Google Keep, or Google Tasks. So these are other applications which you can access from your Google Drive. By clicking on this gear or setting icon, you can manage your notifications and applications. So if I click on this setting and then settings again, then I have the ability to manage my notifications or my Google applications. So this we will discuss later on in detail. So this was a brief tour of the user interface of Google Drive. And now I will discuss all these features in detail in my next videos.